Good evening and Merry Christmas to you. The years seem to go by more quickly. It's just another trip around the sun. And tonight we find ourselves back here gathered together on this Christmas Eve to celebrate the incarnation and also to look forward to Christ's coming again. So a warm welcome to you this evening. Thank you for joining us. Thank you also to those who are joining us remotely. We're glad to have you with us for this candlelight service on Christmas Eve. The program will proceed largely unannounced, and I say that to let you know, those of you who are part of the program, to be aware so that you don't get left behind, but also to those of you in the audience who are singing the hymns. The hymns are listed there, and in several places there are just select verses, so make sure that you know which verses we're singing, how many verses we're singing, so that you don't have that embarrassing solo at the end. We'd hate to have that happen. Let's begin by turning to our hymnals, to hymn number 2, and you'll note there we'll be singing verses 1, 3, and 4. O come, O come, Emmanuel. Will you please stand as we sing? For our call to worship, which tonight is found in John's Gospel and also the Old Testament prophet Isaiah. It's printed in the bulletin. I'll read the leader part and you respond. In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God.
All things were made.
In him was life, and the life was the light of men.
The people that walked in darkness have seen a great light.
And those who dwell in the land of the shadow of death, on them has the light shined. Remain standing as we sing, O come, all ye faithful, hymn number 19.
First candle, prophecy candle, Isaiah chapter 9, 6 to 7. For to us a child is born, to us a son is given, and the government will be on his shoulders, and he will be called Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace.
Of the increase of his government and peace, there will be no end. He will reign on David's throne and over his kingdom, establishing and holding it with justice and righteousness. From that time on and forever, the zeal of the Lord Almighty will accomplish this.
Thank you. The second candle of Advent is the Bethlehem candle. Micah 5:2. But you, Bethlehem Ephrathah, though you are small among the clans of Judah, out of you will come for me one who will be ruler over Israel, whose origins are from of old, from ancient times.
After Jesus was born in Bethlehem in Judea, during the time of King Herod, Magi from the east came to Jerusalem and asked, "Where is the one who has been born King of the Jews? We saw his star in the east and have come to worship him." When King Herod heard this, he was disturbed, and all Jerusalem with him. When he had called together all the people's chief priests and teachers of the law, he asked them where the Christ was to be born. "In Bethlehem in Judea," they replied, "for this is what the prophet has written. But you, Bethlehem, in the land of Judah, are by no means least among the rulers of Judah, for out of you will come a ruler who will be the shepherd of my people." Then Herod called the Magi secretly and found out from them the exact time the star had appeared. He sent them to Bethlehem and said, "Go and make a careful search for the child. As soon as you find him, report to me so that I too may go and worship him." After they had heard the king, they went on their way, and the star they had seen in the east went ahead of them until it stopped over the place where the child was. When they saw the star, they were overjoyed. On coming to the house, they saw the child with his mother Mary, and they bowed down and worshiped him. Then they opened their treasures and presented him with gifts of gold and of incense and myrrh. And having been warned in a dream not to go back to Herod, they returned to their country by another route.
Thank you. The Shepherd's Candle. Luke chapter 2, verses 8 to 20. And there were in the same country shepherds abiding in the fields, keeping watch over their flock by night. And lo, the angel of the Lord came upon them, and the glory of the Lord shone round about them, and they were sore afraid. And the angel said unto them, Fear not, for behold, I bring you good tidings of great joy, which shall be to all the people. For unto you this day in the city of David is born a Savior, which is Christ the Lord. And this shall be a sign unto you. Ye shall find the babe wrapped in a swaddling clothes, lying in a manger. And suddenly there were with the angel a multitude of the heavenly host, praising God and saying, Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace, goodwill toward men.
When the angel had left them and gone into heaven, the shepherds said to one another, Let's go to Bethlehem and see this thing that has happened, which the Lord has told us about. So they hurried off and found Mary and Joseph and the baby, who was lying in the manger. When they had seen him, they spread the word concerning what had been told them about this child. And all who heard it were amazed at what the shepherds said to them. But Mary treasured up all these things and pondered them in her heart. The shepherds returned, glorifying and praising God for all the things they had heard and seen, which were just as they had been told.
Thank you. The fourth candle is the angel's candle, Luke 1:26-37. In the sixth month, God sent the angel Gabriel to Nazareth, a town in Galilee, to a virgin pledged to be married to a man named Joseph, a descendant of David. The virgin's name was Mary. The angel went to her and said, "Greetings, you who are highly favored. The Lord is with you." Mary was greatly troubled at his words and wondered what kind of greeting this might be. But the angel said to her, "Do not be afraid, Mary. You have found favor with God. You will be with child and give birth to a son, and you are to give him the name Jesus. He will be great and will be called the Son of the Most High. The Lord God will give him the throne of his father David, and he will reign over the house of Jacob forever. His kingdom will never end."
"How will this be?" Mary asked the angel, "since I am a virgin." The angel answered, "The Holy Spirit will come upon you, and the power of the Most High will overshadow you. So the Holy One to be born will be called the Son of God. Even Elizabeth, your relative, is going to have a child in her old age, and she who was said to be barren is in her sixth month. For nothing is impossible with God."
Thank you. the fifth candle, the Christ candle. Luke 2, 25 to 32. Now there was a man in Jerusalem called Simeon, who was righteous and devout. He was waiting for the consolation of Israel, and the Holy Spirit was upon him. It had been revealed to him by the Holy Spirit that he would not die before he had seen the Lord's Christ. Moved by the Spirit, he went into the temple courts. When the parents brought in the child Jesus to do for him what was the custom of the law required, Simeon took him in his arms and praised God, saying, "Sovereign Lord, as you have promised, you now dismiss your servant in peace. For my eyes have seen your salvation, which you have prepared in the sight of all people, a light for revelation to the Gentiles and for glory to your people, Israel."
John 8:12. When Jesus spoke again to the people, he said, "I am the light of the world. Whoever follows me will never walk in darkness, but will have the light of life."
There are directions on the back page of your folder about how we do this. The ushers will receive a light and then we'll pass it to the first person on the end of the aisle and you pass it on down. I'd really suggest that the person with the flame hold the candle upright and the person with the unlit candle tip yours, otherwise the wax is going to spill. We have an insert that has words to the first verse of the carols we're going to sing, and if you care to use that, please be careful not to get it too close to the flame. I shouldn't have to say that, but let us begin.
My heart is filled to overflowing. And I hope yours is too tonight. Paul prayed for Christians, for believers, that to have the power together with all the saints to know the love of Christ, the height and depth and length and breadth, to know this love and to be filled with all the fullness of God. Jesus said, I tell you these things so that my joy may be in you and that your joy may be full. The angels proclaim, I bring you good tidings of great joy, which shall be to all people. For to you is born this day in the city of David a Savior, who is Christ the Lord. 2 Corinthians 9:15 says, thanks be to God for his indescribable gift, the gift of our Lord Jesus Christ. I hope you haven't left that gift just wrapped up with a pretty bow on it and thinking that it's so nice you don't want to tear into it. No, he wants you to open that gift to receive Jesus, the Christ, the Messiah, the Savior. And so to be filled with all of his fullness for having received Jesus, you receive all God's fullness. And so with the angels, let us proclaim that joy. And may the joy of Jesus, be yours this Christmas and throughout all the new year. Heavenly Father, thank you for all that you have given us in Jesus. And may we receive this gift and thank you for it. And Father, may we share that joy. In Jesus' name, amen. God be with you.